ETF.com video series. We're here at Inside ETFs. I'm Cynthia Murphy, and today we have Mike Venuto, Chief Investment Officer at Torozzo Investments with us. Thanks for joining us, Mike.
Happy to be here.
You have the only ETF in the market that's the ETF of the ETF industry. Since inception last April, it's up 35%. It's outperformed SPY, it's outperformed XLF, which is the financials ETF. We all know ETF market is growing by leaps and bounds. Should we look at this ETF as a reflection of that growth? Should we look at it as directly correlated? Mm-hmm. How should we look at the ETF performance?
So we designed it to track the growth of the industry. That's why it's not just ETF issuers, right? It also has the exchanges, it has the liquidity providers, it has the back offices and the index companies. Pretty much everybody that's here is in the index. And the idea was that for the last 10 years, ETFs have been growing about 20% a year. We wanted to make that our benchmark. How do we capture that growth? Last year, ETFs actually grew closer to 35. Feel pretty good about that
35.
Tracking.
35. Yeah, it's on the money then.
That was the intent.
Do you expect that kind of rate of growth to continue? Should we expect 35 years? I mean, everybody has really bullish expectations. Are you on that camp, I'm guessing? Yes.
So I think that 20% annualized growth makes a lot of sense. It's that kind of pattern that's been going on. One of the things that's weird is ETFs and the industry itself tend to grow when markets decline. So the first year that ETFs outpaced mutual funds was 2008. So there's this unique situation where this is a part of the financial ecosystem that actually benefits from a bear market. I do believe it's going to grow. We send you the newsletters each week where we talk about two growth factors for ETFs. One being client alignment factors. The fact that they're inexpensive, they're transparent, they're liquid. And the other we call innovation factors. It's the fact that every day somebody new is coming up with a great idea that is just better delivered in the ETF wrapper.
Where does this ETF belong in a portfolio? Is it like a satellite to something like XLF, a financials? Does it stand on its own?
So I look at it as kind of two places. Number one, if you're going to own financials, why own a bunch of antiquated companies that are, you know, at risk because they're not aligned with clients and they're not innovating? But two, if you believe this industry is going to grow and you know that there's limited return expectations for the rest of the US markets, why not participate in the growth that is aligned with clients? It's simply a way to add alpha to an existing portfolio.
Great. Well, congratulations on the performance. Thanks for joining me today. We are here again at Inside ETFs. This is Mike Venuto, and for more videos, check out ETF.com.